Robert Maxwell clinched his hold on Watford's printing industry 2 weeks ago when he bought Odams off Reed International, adding it to the town's Sun Printers, which he already owned. Since then, there's been speculation that one of the plants is certain to close. Tonight, Robert Maxwell wouldn't say which one, but he made it clear that massive redundancies are certain.
I have estimated, and this is only an estimate at the present time, something like 1,200 jobs will go at both Odams and Sun.
That's a very bitter blow for the town. Do you feel there's no way around those redundancies?
It is indeed a bitter blow, but the alternative is to have both plants shut, which would have been the case had the deal between Mr. Leslie Carpenter and myself not been concluded, and very speedy negotiations only a few weeks ago.
The way it looks to me, a minimum of 1,200, if not 1,500 people will be losing their jobs in this town, which will be a disaster for the town, not just for those who are employed in the printing industry and the ancillary trades that supply the two big houses of Sun and Odams, but even the local shopkeepers. I mean, if it was to Odams that was to go down the pan and because of his plan, then certainly this side of Watford would become like a ghost town, I should think.
2,700 people work for Sun and Odams in Watford, and all now face a Christmas wondering how secure their jobs are. In addition to job losses, union leaders fear the cuts will make it impossible to bring back lost print business to the town, which will no longer have the capacity to deal with it.
There's no danger at all. I have recently acquired a major catalogue, the Argos catalogue, which we lost to the Italians on fair terms, back to this country. It's worth £7 million over 2 years. We have ample capacity in this industry and in this country to cope.
Tonight, print workers in Watford still don't know where the Jobs Act will fall. Robert Maxwell has promised an announcement within the next few days, but meanwhile he goes into negotiations with the elements of surprise and uncertainty on his side. This is Steve Clark for Thames News in Watford.